Hey everybody, it's day six, 30 ways that you can change, enhance, improve, design your own life. And thank you, I've had just a blast over the last few days. We've had tons of people share. I'm going to thank some of the people that shared on day four. Day four was let it go and go grow. And if you don't know me, my name is Steve Melia. I'm an entrepreneur. I am a part-time stand-up comic. I'm an author of a couple of books. I'm a Yankees fanatic. I love the Grateful Dead and Company now. I'm an independent associate with a network marketing company. I've done very well with that, Legal Shield. And I'm a professional speaker. More than anything, I'm just a lover of life, and I love to help people. I love to encourage other people and see other people live their dreams. And today is day six. And if it's okay with you, I am going to review what we've talked about in the first 5 days. I'm going to do it very quickly. Number one, day one, we talked about developing success habits. The number one thing is getting your day started right by writing your goals, your affirmations, what you've done over the last 24 hours to progress your goals, and then what you're grateful for. Day two, we talked about law of associations, birds of a feather flock together, and how important that is. Day three, we talked about the slight edge philosophy. Day four was Thanksgiving, and I asked many of you to share every day, share this post, but many of you did so. I think I had 60 people share just on Thanksgiving Day, so I really appreciate that. My goal is to get my message out to as many people as possible. I'm going to be reading those names here of everybody that gets a free copy of 162 or The Last 42, whichever book you desire. Day five, we talked about goal setting. And today, day six, it's a very simple philosophy. You know, you hear a lot of quotes. And as far as I know, there's only one quote that I ever really came up with myself. And it's very simple. It's doing leads to doing, and waiting leads to waiting. It's really playing off the law of momentum, which says that an object in motion tends to stay in motion, and an object at rest tends to stay at rest. And so today we're going to be talking about taking action. Yesterday we talked about goal setting. Now I'm going to ask you over the next few minutes to take three of the things that you pointed out were important to you. Maybe it was a career goal, maybe it was a health goal, maybe it was a relationship goal. But let's say that your three goals are earning $10,000 per month, losing 20 pounds by February 1st, and getting married within 24 months. Let's say those are your three goals. I'm going to ask you to do today is act as if success is certain. Take each one of those goals and just write down one thing that you could do. Not just write it down. Go do one thing that will lead you towards one of those goals. And so, Mike, it's good to see you. If you notice, I'm having a little bit of bad hair day. Ran out of my hair gel, and I've got a gray stripe coming in there as well, showing my age a little bit. Let's see who we got. I got Nate Dillard. Nate, thanks for being on. Dan. Hey, Dan. Long time. No see. How you been, buddy? Michael Scott. Chris Frazier from Florida. Chris has been dialing in every day. Chris, appreciate you, buddy. I see my brother Mike Melia is on. Junior, good to see you. And I got Christopher as well. And Mike, be careful with your comments here, buddy. And so what I'm going to do right now, guys, is just thank a few of the – I'm going to thank everybody that shared on Thursday, which was Thanksgiving. And if I butcher your name, I'm sorry. I'm going to do this quickly, but I really appreciate it. I want to give you guys special recognition. Brock Hildreth, Lynn Schulzer-Williams. These are all people that shared the post 2 days ago. So if you'd like to share this post today, please share. Susan Pepler, Palka, Greg Engelman, Jeff Stewart, Timothy Wickard, Nori Scott, Gene Leiter, Junior Pergon, Gloria Robinson, Sharanda Ivy, Deborah Crawley, Brian Hassett, Tony Harrell, Brad Hall, Abigail Bass, Chris Frazier, Kyron Williams, Jim Vaughn, Sarah Jean Dye, Michael Armstrong, Eric Gray, Doug Sams, Rich Kennedy, Matt Curry, Guillermo Rubio, Bill Geithner, Mike Bishop, Timmer Halligan, Paula Londono, Samer Samander. Good luck with your Alabama team today, buddy. Bew Carlisle, Mary Lynn up in Canada, my brother Mike Melia, Baseball Talk, which is a great, if you like baseball, a buddy of mine, the memory expert Ron White, heads up that website, does an amazing job. John Curtin, Carla Hernandez, Louis Adelman, PPL Group, Dave Lean, Jody Eason, and Adam Elder are all getting a book. And so, guys, I will be messaging you guys for your address in any book that you want. Which brings me, before I get into my main message today, I'm going to offer a very special buy one, get one free for either one of my books. Now, those people are all receiving free books, but for anybody else, if you go to my website right now and you get a book, it'll be $15 plus shipping and handling, so $18. But if you get one, just say that you'd like an extra one for a friend for a Christmas present, and I'll, at no cost, no more shipping, I'll throw in an extra copy. If you get however many books that you get, I will double your order, and simply put in the comment box which book that you would like. And you would say, well, I don't know anything about your books. I'll give you a quick commercial. 162, it's probably backwards. It says probably 261. 162, guys, are how many games are in a baseball season? In 2011, with literally just 30 days notice, I made the commitment that I was going to attend every New York Yankee game in one season. And from what I could tell, no one had ever done it and paid their own way. A few friends of mine, Bald Vinny up in New York, was part of a reality show, and he, as well as three other fans, went to every game. But I said, you know what? I know a lot of people across the country. I'm an entrepreneur. I got cash flow. So why not go to every game? And I wrote an amazing book. If you've read the book, you probably loved it, because most people did. And then a few years later, I wrote a second book called The Last 42. Many of you know Jackie Robinson was number 42, and they retired his number. Well, Mariano Rivera was grandfathered in. He was one of 13 players still wearing that number. So until it was in his end of his career, they let him wear it. Man, I got some likes from Mariano there. If you like Mariano Rivera, give me some likes right now, guys. He was a stud. You guys can do better than that. And had some tragedy hit my family a couple years back when my brother Jim, Jim is pictured here in the cover. He's in the middle between my brothers, Mike and myself. And Jim was an amazing guy, 6'6", was a basketball star in high school and some of college. And he passed away suddenly. And really, to grieve, I just decided to go to the last 42 games of that season, sort of tying it in. I was sitting with my brother the day after he passed away, and I said, I got my next idea. I'm going to attend the last 42 games of Mariano Rivera's career. And there were about 6 weeks left in the season. I did that. It was amazing. If you like this book, you'll love this book. And so anybody that wants to put in an order today, I'd love to send you a free copy. Get one for yourself. And pick up the second book, or if you've read both books and you want to just pick up a copy for some other folks, do that. And for those of you that won a free book, I'm also going to make you a special deal for just $10 extra, since I'm already shipping it anyway. Just let me know how many extra books you want for Christmas presents, and if I'm already sending you a free one, just ask. And say I want four more copies of 162, and then you could just go to PayPal and pay me for those, okay? If you want to check out my new website, it's the162guy.com. Real simple to remember, the162guy.com. So thank you for letting me get all those commercials out of the way. And one of my goals really is to inspire people to live their dreams, and that's really what both books are about. It's about having a dream and being committed to seeing that dream come true. So let's see who else we got here. Hey, Rose, out in Vegas, how are you? Long time. Gage, thanks for being on. Karen is watching. We've got Gloria Robinson, who I just read her name, is getting a free book. Ted Wilson as well. Carla, great to see you. Harold, thanks for being on. Doc Wilson, Daryl Anderson, Deborah Crowley, all great to see everybody. And I'm going to get back to my main message. And, you know, when I first got started in business, my brother and I have been business partners for going on 25 years. I think it'll be 25 years this coming April. It will be 2018, and actually 2019. We're celebrating our 24th year right now. And one of the things, if you followed us around all day, you could argue that we were not necessarily motivated all the time. We were a little bit lazy, quite frankly. And but I tell you what, when we first got the vision of a new company that we were working with, all of a sudden we went from, people would have said we were lazy, especially if they watched our actions, but all of a sudden we went from people that just sort of sat around and maybe waited for things to happen sometimes, to taking action, massive action. And if you knew us, we had the reputation of being almost workaholics. Like, that's all we could do was work and talk about work and think about work. And we were just so excited about the project that we have on. So yesterday we talked about goal setting, and hopefully you're excited about your goals. But now that you have an idea, it's time to take action. My brother Mike is famous for saying that act as if success were certain. If you knew, let's say we had a psychic here and I looked at your goals and I said, these three goals are going to come true. And I tell you, I know that. It's a done deal. The universe has already said it. And if you knew that, what action would you do? What's the very first step that you would take? Because I'm going to tell you, doing leads to more doing and waiting leads to more waiting, right? The law of momentum states that an object in motion tends to stay in motion, and an object at rest tends to stay at rest. The longer you stay at rest, the harder it is to get going. So maybe it's going to the gym. Maybe it's making that phone call. Maybe you got a grudge against somebody that you haven't called back. I'm going to urge you right now to take three of your goals that we talked about from yesterday, or if you weren't on yesterday, feel free to go back and watch it, or just start from scratch right now. It doesn't matter. Doing leads to doing, and waiting leads to waiting. That is my message today. There's one book that I read recently, and many of you did. In fact, I had the honor to share the stage with this young lady, Mel Robbins, last year in Oklahoma City. I've seen her speak three times now over the last year. On one of those, I was actually one of the speakers myself, which was pretty cool. But Mel Robbins wrote a book called The 5-Second Rule. And she actually even jokes as she speaks. She says, no, it's not about how long you should wait when you drop food, on the floor, 5 seconds. What the 5-second rule is, it's very simple, very simple rule. It actually, hit like if you've ever seen Mel speak, or if you've read the book, or if you've actually done this, or you're doing this yourself, because I'd be interested to see who else has done the 5-second rule. Man, we got a lot of new people joining us as well. Hello, Maureen, my sister-in-law out of New York. Great to see you. Jason. Hey, Jason, thanks for, it was great to see you recently, I think, in Vegas. Justin, Jim, who else we got? Thank you guys for joining. But the 5-second rule is pretty simple. Whenever you think of something to do, count down like a rocket ship. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, and then do whatever. And what happens is you're blocking out all of the noise, all of the doubt that seeps in. As soon as we think of an idea, sometimes if you're like me, all these ideas come in of why not to do something. Like you pick up the phone to call a prospect you haven't followed up within 6 months, and all of a sudden your mind says, oh, they're probably not home. It's a Saturday. They're going to be mad at you for not following up. And we talk ourselves out of doing it. What I'm saying, as soon as you think of Bill's name, say, Bill, dial Bill's number, pick up the phone, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, go, right? You want to go to the gym today, but all of a sudden you decide, what's all the reasons I shouldn't go? 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, get dressed and go to the gym. Whatever your goal is, whatever your desire is, launch yourself in action by 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Again, if you haven't watched one of these live broadcasts for 30 days, I'm doing 30 ways for 30 days that you can enhance, improve, design your own life. Wouldn't that be great if you could just design your own life? Well, guess what? You can. You are the author of your own life. We talked about that yesterday. Take authority for it and start taking action. Doing leads to more doing, and waiting leads to more waiting. Okay? I'm going to sort of talk a little bit now about advanced action. Okay? Everybody needs to take action. One step will lead to the next. A couple things that I'm going to talk about. You know, first of all, let's say you're getting up in the morning and you're figuring out, okay, you're making a list of things to do. If you read Brian Tracy's book called Eat That Frog, what he talks about is, actually, that's an interesting concept, right? Eating a frog. It's a great way to get people to read your book. But what he talks about is find the most important goal, the goal that would make everything easier, the hardest goal usually. If there's one person on that list that you didn't really feel like calling back, or a situation you didn't feel like dealing with, deal with that situation first. And I'm telling you, it's such a burden off of you that the next phone call is easier. But it's important to make that next phone call. You know, just make one more. My first couple years in business, as Mike and I were building our first network marketing company and our first network marketing business, we were just action-oriented. One more. And the whole idea is, if you have a bad phone call, you got to jump on the phone and have a great one. If you have a great one, you need to feed off that momentum and use the energy from the first one to go to the second one, to go to the third one. So whatever your goals are, right? Whatever your goal is, maybe it's to write a book. You know, when I first started writing a book, day one was probably the hardest day. But I set my alarm clock for 6:45. By 7 a.m., I was in front of my computer, and I would stay there until between 9 and 10, and I did it 5 to 6 days a week. Doing leads to doing, and waiting leads to waiting. So if you like the message that I'm sharing with you today, do me a big favor and get this out. Just hit the share button. Go down to the bottom right now. Hit the share button. Yesterday, I had 16 shares, which is fine. You know, I had, I think, 10 the first 3 days, 60 the fourth day that I gave away a free book. I could tell you guys like free stuff. And today being the sixth, or yesterday, I had about 16 shares. Let's see how many that you can do today. I see Desiree, good to see you. You, Morgan, thanks for being on. And we had a lot of people dialing in today. And so I've been doing these Facebook Lives, just trying to get the word out that success is possible, but you gotta dream it, you gotta believe it. And my message for today, guys, is take action. Doing leads to doing, waiting leads to waiting. I'm gonna end right now, and what I want you to do is I want you to share this for me as a special favor, and I would certainly appreciate it. For those of you that are looking for holiday presents, I recommend that you go to my website, the162guy.com. If you're not ready to get anything, fine, but just go check it out. Let me know what you think. I just launched it here recently, so it's still gonna add a lot of stuff to it, but it's ready for you to see. And just go to the bottom and order yourself a book. It'll be with shipping and handling $18, but guess what? It'll only be $9 because you get two books, right? If you want to get three, that's only $25 for two books, and you'll get four books, and you can keep doing the math. If you have any questions, you can just email me through the site and let me know. And for those of you that have ordered, that shared on Thursday, and you were nice enough to do that, I'm going to be sending you a copy of either 162 or the last 42. I'll be inboxing you after my Facebook Live today. But thank you, everybody. See if there's any more comments or anybody else that's joined. Mary Lynn from Canada has joined. Good to see you. Donna Bloomer from Wilmington area. Louise Brown is on as well. Well, we certainly appreciate everybody tuning in. And remember, if you haven't watched these the first five, go back and watch from the beginning, usually about 15 to 20 minutes if you're interested. We talked about developing success habits, and I'm going to revisit that one real quick before I wrap up. The most important thing with that is to make sure that your telephone is in a place where you cannot reach it in the morning, okay? I do not want you to go to your telephone until you do four things. Write down 10 or 15 goals. Write down five things that you're grateful for. Write down five things that you did, hopefully you have at least five, over the last 24 hours that have helped progress one of your goals, maybe exercised, maybe you made a phone call to somebody you had a grudge against, whatever. And then fourth, read over your affirmations. And guess what? We are going to be talking about affirmations tomorrow, so I'm excited about that. So it'll be Sunday, but it's going to be a great day. And once again, we'll be live here. Do me a favor, guys. Last but not least, just share this. Go to your share button right now. Do your buddy, the 162 guy, Steve Mealy, a big favor, and I'm going to see who actually went out and shared this today. Thank you for helping me live my dreams, and if there's anything I can ever do for anybody that's watching this, please just ask. Ask and you shall receive. Ask and you, or knock and you shall find. I'm not really sure. But I will end with a quote from the Bible. My brother Mike actually sent this to me yesterday when he heard of my topic. He said, "Faith without works is dead. Faith without works is dead." That means you got to take action. Believing is a great thing, but we got to take action. Doing leads to doing, and waiting leads to more waiting. God bless, and have a great day. Bye-bye.